Is your name on this year's hurricane name list? This year's list starts with Alberto and ends with William. 21 names in total. So how do these names get chosen, and why do we name storms in the first place? Simply put, a name is easier to communicate than latitude and longitude. And experts say a name is also easier to remember when more than one storm is being tracked at a time. Early on, storms were given the name of the Saint's Day when the storm occurred. Then, during World War II, there was a widespread practice among Army and Navy meteorologists of only naming storms after women. The US adopted this practice in 1953, starting with Alice. By 1979, the National Hurricane Center began adding male names to the list, starting with Bob. And coincidentally, the name Bob came around again in 1991. Some of you may remember this, and that's actually the last hurricane to make landfall in southern New England. Today, Atlantic tropical storm names are maintained by an international committee of the World Meteorological Organization. There are 6 lists of names in rotation, and they get recycled every 6 years. That means the 2023 list will reappear again in 2029. The committee selects names familiar to people in the areas of the world where the storms form. When picking a new name, they consider shorter names that are, for the most part, easy to pronounce. In most regions, they're named alphabetically, alternating between male and female names. Now, if a named storm turns extremely destructive or deadly, that international committee will discuss whether to retire the name. That's happened with storm names like Katrina, Sandy, and most recently, Fiona and Ian. So, is your name on deck this year? You can find the full list at WCVB.com.